My name's Oliver. I'm a graduate from UCT firstly and then from the London Film School. And I'm going to talk to you about my graduation project, which is a feature film called Shirley Adams. But I'm going to talk to you specifically about the construction of characters. So as a filmmaker, we shoot people. We design them, we create them, we create scenarios for the characters, and then we capture them and we show them to you, an audience. And different kinds of filmmakers want different kinds of responses. I want you to be affected. I want my work to linger with you after you've left the theater. The first time I was ever left with an image that lingered with me was this one by Kevin Carter. This is a story. There are two characters. And it was a story that the world saw, and the attention of the world went to this particular country. It was this kind of experience, this kind of reaction that I wanted to be able to create for an audience. I started by looking at the characters in my life, my friends, trying to find images or single image, or taking a single image, to try and encapsulate for you, or for me at least, an element of them that I wanted to remember, to the point where I could look at the image years later and still have an essence of what those friends meant to me, if whether or not I still knew them. What I also started doing subconsciously was looking at the elements of my friends and starting to sort of steal behavioral types, memories, hopes, dreams, and keeping them. Then I met this guy. We lived together for 1 year here in Cape Town, both of us working as photographers for the Cape Times and the Cape Argus, and we spent our entire lives talking about photography. He's referring to his hands because we were obsessed with this quote by Henri Cartier-Bresson, which is the decisive moment, the moment when a photographer actually clicks the camera, because this is the moment that the newspaper is going to publish, but it's also the story the newspaper is going to show. For us, there was only one photographer who did this best, James Nachtwey. Nachtwey goes to the most difficult parts of the world, and his entire intention is to introduce you to characters and faces and eyes and moments that you can't forget. So we tried to do this. We traveled the world to the G8 summit, photographing events. But I was beginning to feel frustrated because a single image does not give you enough information about a character. For example, in this image, you don't know that this woman is going to be evicted from her house today, that she has nowhere else to go, and that she even painted the number 11 on the side of the house to make her kids feel like they had an address. This information would be in a caption, but I knew this information because I met her. So I started looking at ways of using more images, 25 images per second for 90 minutes. This is Rosetta. She's the subject of a film by the Dardenne brothers. I saw this film when I went to London to film school, and it changed the way I thought about designing a character. Because in this film, you only see one character. You see nothing else. I don't even know which city Rosetta lives in. I know that she's 15, that she wants a job, and that she'll do anything to get a job. And this film revolutionized the way that I thought about a character. This is my sister. My sister told me a story when I was 15 about a family she was working with in Mitchell's Plain who had a disabled son, and he had been shot in the back of the neck and was rendered a tetraplegic. She was a student working with the family, trying to teach them new methods of helping him. The problem was that the family was not coping with the disability, and my sister didn't know what to do. She was talking to my mother. I was eavesdropping. But I remembered this character of this boy because he was the same age as me. In my photography, I still kept thinking about him. What was he like as a child? What were his memories? Who were his friends? I also decided that as a character, if you're disabled, what do you lose when you have no movement of your body from the neck down? I decided that character, my character, Donovan, was a swimmer. He would go to Camps Bay on New Year's Day with his family, which is the one time when non-white people go to this side of the city and use the beach. What is the psychology of this character? When you work with an actor to talk about the character, you have to give them visual references. This is what I gave my actor. Something to symbolize what the character might wonder about their future sex life, their future romance. How do you personify someone who can't swim anymore? What is the details of the way that the character must struggle to find a way of reordering their life when they know that everything that they wanted and dreamed of disappeared? What does the character's house look like? I know Mitchell's Plain, but what are the real details of Mitchell's Plain? What do the houses look like? There are different kinds of houses. It's an area that was built at the end during apartheid. It was where people were moved to from District 6. And what does it look like now? What are the textures of that house? And when I started thinking about the textures, I suddenly started thinking about Donovan's mother, because she would define these things. She would choose the drapes that often matched the curtains, that often matched the bedding, that often matched what she was wearing, often matched her shoes, which is, I'm sure you know, a very popular colored trend. And so I started thinking about the women in my family. I have now three generations of my family. And I started thinking about my mother and what she would do if I had been shot in the back of the neck and was rendered a tetraplegic. And so my attention shifted from the design of Donovan to the design of his mother, who I named Shirley. Because I have photographed women who I know and who I don't know for so long, I started taking all those things that I had stolen from my friends, young and old, and started constructing this character. I decided many things about her, which we would call facts of the character, and they would become the things I would end up talking to the actress about. What is the politics of my character? Is she a DA supporter? I took this image of Helen Zille when she was going to become the mayor. She had funded a fundraiser in a stadium in Goodwood and served alcohol to the guests. They got drunk. Did my character go to this event? What was her decision? What are the actors? Who are the actors that I reference? Who are the actresses? Who are the faces? One of the most important things in the end product of a film is that it's the eyes. The characters exist in the eyes of the actor. Who are the actors whose eyes, for me, light up a screen, who deliver performances that I remember? And then finally, this is Shirley Adams, sitting in a bus stop, having just found out that the man who shot her son is a family friend, and she now has to go home and tell her tetraplegic son that the person who destroyed their life was someone who they knew. Thank you. Thank you.